Thank you for coming this morning. The American people have spoken. They made clear what we have known for months. President Donald J. Trump is our Republican nominee and will be the 47th president of the United States. His America First agenda secured our borders, made America energy independent, and always puts the needs of the American people first. That is not the State of the Union we will hear from Joe Biden this week. Because the American people deeply understand that under Joe Biden's failed presidency, the State of the Union is in crisis. And this is a crisis of Joe Biden's making. As Ronald Reagan famously asked us, are you better off today than you were 4 years ago? The answer for hardworking Americans across the country is a resounding no. Whether it's the catastrophic border crisis ravaging our nation and leading to tragic loss of life of American citizens, the painful Bidenflation causing middle-class families to struggle to make ends meet, or our most precious ally, Israel, facing the bloodiest day since the Holocaust, as Joe Biden projects weakness around the globe. Joe Biden has failed America and the American people. And at what will be his final State of the Union, Joe Biden and the White House will desperately try to pass the buck, blame Congress, and shirk responsibility in a desperate attempt to reset his abysmal presidency. But it won't work because the American people are smart. There is no reset button for Joe Biden. Even the Democrats' loyal stenographers in the mainstream media have been forced to acknowledge that Joe Biden is a deteriorating president with a failed record and polling in free fall. Each of our House Republican members will host a guest that highlights the Joe Biden State of the Union in crisis, whether it's Border Patrol officers like my guest from the North Country, Brandon Budlong, or families who have lost loved ones due to Joe Biden's dangerous open border policies. Each of our members who will speak today will talk about these issues as we prepare to hear from Joe Biden this week. And one of the members who understands the impact of Joe Biden's crises firsthand is Congresswoman Jen Kagans from Virginia's 2nd Congressional District. Jen.
Thank you so much. And thank you very much for being here to